What's up, gamers? Welcome back to Disney Dreamlight Valley. It is the day before the big October update, Jungle Getaway, where we'll be bringing Timon and Pumbaa to the valley. I had planned on sharing the patch notes with you guys yesterday, but it doesn't look like the developers are sharing that with us ahead of time for this update. Usually they share the patch notes at least a couple of days before, and we're able to go over everything that we can look forward to. In case you're unfamiliar, the patch notes just kind of show everything that's going to change, any bug fixes that they're going to include, and all of the content that they're going to be adding. So it's really a fun thing to look at before we get the update so we know exactly what to expect. But unfortunately, I don't have those to share with you. I'm not really 100% sure why they're not sharing really much of anything leading up to this one. But I did want to give you a video this week, other than the one that I will be posting tomorrow, going over the update, showing the new star path and the premium shop and all of that. So I thought I would just show you some of the preparations that I'm doing in my valley for this update. So I have actually been working on my Sunlit Plateau. So this biome has been the most neglected probably out of all of the biomes, but I will give you a little tour. So we have over here the entrance, obviously. And then we do have Scar's little area, and I left this kind of the way that it was. Here, let's get rid of these bones. So as you can see, we have Scar's house here still. I did add this fun sand fountain, I guess it's called. This is from the Eternity Isle expansion. And then we've got some more bones and just a little cooking area over here. So this is pretty much the same as it always has been. And then we have one of my favorite things in my valley, and that's my orchard. So as you can see, I'm still working on some stuff. Actually, let's do this part together. Go ahead and finish this. I ran out of paths, so I had to build more paths. But yeah, I wanted to build a cute little entrance here for my Wally and Eve area. Okay, what do we think of that? I might have to change that. I might just have to make this. Hang on, let me do that. Okay, here we go. What do we think of this? I think that looks a lot better. So let's go ahead and look over here. I have Wally and Eve set up with all of my trees and bushes so that I can collect everything really quickly and easily. And it's all in one spot. And I've got it kind of decorated with, you know, Wally type items. I've got Wally's little garden over here as well. A little picnic table. And yeah, I really enjoy this area a lot. It's really functional and it works out really well. And then over here, I have my well. And right next to the well, I have Goofy's doll. I've got some chests and my crafting table. And this just makes it easy when I fast travel here to get straight to Goofy's little stall. And it's right next to the mines. So I just think this is a really good location for this well to be. All right, so across the little bridge, I just have this fountain and these camels and of course my Mickey Ferris wheel. So I thought about doing like a carnival over here, but I don't know, I just can't get it to look the way that I want it to. So I've just kind of left this area a little bit open. I've got a Dreamlight tree back there, which I think looks so beautiful. And then we have Simba and Nala's house back here, Pride Rock. Yeah, not a lot, just a few little decorations here and there. Then over here on this side, I've just got this little like seating area and then another little seating area. And that's it. That's the whole Sunlit Plateau. So one thing that I do every time that we have an update coming is that I just allow the night thorns to grow freely so that I have those to collect, because there are a few of the star path duties that require you to collect night thorns. So I just let those grow. So we're not going to worry about that. I have been logging on every day to try to find my blue chests for the moonstones, because we definitely want to have moonstones stocked up for the update, because we're going to get a lot of new things in the premium shop. And of course, if you want to upgrade the Star Pass, you'll need Moonstones for that as well. I forgot to mention that when I do add Timon and Pumbaa to the valley, I'm assuming that I'm going to place them over here in the Sunlit Plateau. That's why I was showing it to you guys in the first place. I don't know if I actually said that out loud. But yeah, I think I'm going to put them over here somewhere, depending on what their house looks like and how big it is. But it's definitely going to go in this area somewhere. Now, in the update tomorrow, we are going to head back to the Lion King realm. So I kind of want to go in there right now. So right now, the realm is always in nighttime mode, but when we get the update, it's going to change from nighttime to daytime. While we're in here, let's go ahead and look for some stuff, some glimmer. I love that we can just hold the button down now. I know a lot of people wanted that change a long time ago. I've also been working on my Dream Snap submission. Let me just go ahead and show it to you guys. I usually show it on Wednesdays, but I'll go ahead and show it to you now. So this week we had the Dreamlight Western Outfit Challenge. And this is what I have come up with. Now, I have seen a lot of inspiration online that are just so much better than what I have come up with here, but I'm pretty proud of this. I know that it's probably not going to do as well as some of the ones that I've seen, but I'm hoping that it does okay because I know there are lots of really good things coming to the premium shop, and I'm definitely going to need Moonstones for that. But let me know what you think. I tried to do like a little Western town kind of deal. Now, here is my fall submission. This is the one that we are going to get our results for tomorrow. I'm really hoping that this is a 4K Moonstones situation because I'm for sure going to upgrade the Star Path and everything. And I'm probably going to end up buying Moonstones if I'm going to be totally honest, because I tend to buy Moonstones for the updates just because I want to be able to do everything and show you guys everything. But if this was a high score, that would really help me out a lot. I kind of want to do some voting because I've seen so many amazing submissions. And I feel like this challenge in particular is like one of my absolute favorites. I love the fall. I love the Halloween time. So let's just rapid fire some of these, shall we? Let's see if we find any. I've seen some really amazing ones. And I was like, dang, I wish I was recording during that. Oh, look at all the little fireflies. So beautiful. I really love how this looks like a beautiful park, though. Gosh, it's so tough to decide sometimes. Oh, this is really beautiful. And I don't always love to show you guys who I'm voting for because I don't want to upset anyone. But I think it's okay. I think... just don't take it personally if I don't vote for yours, okay? They're all lovely. Like, these are both really beautiful. But I do like the way this one draws my eye. So this is the one I'm going to go with. Oh, wow. These are both really good. Oh, man. Look at Jack Skellington in the back of this one. Oh, my God. So cute. Oh, these are beautiful, too. Whoa, look at this one. It like glitched out. Oh no. Whoa, look at how cute. Oh, she looks so cool. I love that. Wow. Oh, that's so beautiful. Oh my gosh. Oh, I love this. And look at how she has the crates in the back to kind of like fill out this wooded area. That's very smart. Oh, man, here's another really cute one. Whoa, yeah, I feel like a lot of people really enjoyed this challenge because I've seen so many that were just so well done. Like, look at this. Oh, man. See, some of these are really hard to choose between. Oh, my goodness, jack-o'-lanterns everywhere. Oh, wow. Oh, look at Figaro. Oh, man. How do you decide? Oh, there's my cat making an appearance. Oh, wow. So good. Oh, I love this. That's so beautiful. Sithi, be quiet, kitty. Oh, wow. That's crazy. Look at that. That is gorgeous. Oh my gosh. Wow. Now I'm like really not feeling as confident with mine anymore. This is beautiful. And the fox just happens to be in a very, very good spot here. Well, this one's really well done. Man, you guys are so good at dream snaps, man. I wish that I was that good at dream snaps. Oh my gosh, Sithi, I'm trying to talk to the people. All right, you guys. Well, I hope that you are enjoying the game and that you are getting ready for this update that's coming tomorrow. Keep in mind that it is going to be a smaller update, okay? So we're not getting a new realm. We're just going back to the Lion King realm. The Star Path is a rock star concert theme, which I know some people are a little bit upset that it's not a Halloween themed Star Path, but no worries because we are getting a new Halloween item. The Halloween event is returning, which I will make a separate video on probably next week showing you how you can get all of those jack-o'-lanterns and things like that. But yeah, if you haven't already, make sure that you subscribe to the channel and turn on your notifications because I am trying to get 10,000 subscribers by the end of the year. And I do think that we can get it because we are very close. We're on the way there. And you'll definitely want your notifications on because I will be going live tomorrow at 1:30 p.m. to live stream the update and play with you guys. So I really hope that I see you there. All right, my friends, I hope that you have a magical rest of your day, and I will see you again real soon. Bye.